So, besides video games and anime, I'm actually a big fan of history and folklore. I'm a sophisticated man, you see. The Witch in the Lighthouse are a couple of my favorite movies, and I actually own a couple of history books of my own. And I've even met Aaron Mankey, the man behind the Lore podcast. Pretty neat, huh? He's a nice guy. I like him a lot. And speaking of podcasts, recently I found myself listening to a podcast called Mythical Monsters, and I happened upon an episode about the Tanuki, and holy balls! This creature ended up fascinating me, and I want to talk about it with you guys. So, you know, why don't you sit your butt down on a log or a stool as we sit around the campfire? And, I don't know, let's potentially start a new series of videos where I gush about some folk tales. Probably not. Rate, comment, subscribe, please. So, for the majority of my audience, they may recognize the Tanuki from Super Mario or even Animal Crossing. But the Tanuki ranges back from thousands and thousands of years ago. The Tanuki are a kind of yokai. Yokai are supernatural monsters, spirits, or demons in Japanese folklore. The Tanuki are known for being keen shapeshifters and for being pranksters to humans and their rivals, the Kitsune, or the foxes. They can shapeshift into stones, trees, and even household items. Like, could you imagine, like, putting your bread in a toaster and it just eats it because it's actually a raccoon that just eats your bread. And also, as seen in Animal Crossing, the Tanuki will try to pass off leaves or scraps of paper as money. They do this in order to exchange, you know, for valuables and for goods. They gotta make that money, you know? And so that's why when you shake a tree in Animal Crossing, a full refrigerator will just come out of the tree as a leaf instead of, you know, a full refrigerator. And, you know, for the most part, the Tanuki are jovial creatures. They're delightful, they're cute, they're raccoons, they drum on their stomachs, and they have magical balls. But for real though, the most famous attribute that the Tanuki possess is their massive, malleable, magical wupples, in which they can adapt to any need. They can fly with them, they can fish with them, they can make truck drivers crash with them, and they will even beat the ever-living shiz out of you with them. Just peep this clip real quick, you'll see what I mean. While in the West, this may be seen as extremely comical, which, come on, it's pretty incredible. Or it may be extremely offensive, which, calm down, for goodness sake. I absolutely love this aspect of the Tanuki. It's awesome, it's wholly unique, and in Japan, it's simply and inoffensively part of the legend that makes up the Tanuki. But the Tanuki are so much more than their dangling participles. Although they are indeed mischief makers, they are happy-go-lucky and they're extremely loyal to their kind and to their friends. One of my favorite stories regarding the Tanuki is, and please forgive my pronunciation, but one of my favorite stories is Bonbuku Chagama, Chagama. I, again, don't like the video, please. I'm sorry. And this basically translates to happiness boiling over like a teapot. So the story goes as follows. A peasant sets free a tanuki that was caught in a trap, and the tanuki in return offers to repay the peasant with a favor. The tanuki transforms into a kettle, and the peasant sells the kettle to a priest, and the priest puts the kettle over the fire, probably to make, you know, some soup or some tea or something. And the kettle subsequently shouts, "Ow!" And, you know, if I was a kettle put over a fire, I would probably be screaming a lot more than just, "Ouch," let's be real. So, unable to stand the heat, the tanuki returns to the peasant, and they decide to, you know, do a new trick. And they come up with this awesome scheme to perform to the public. And the performance is the tanuki does acrobatic feats as a half teapot and a half tanuki, and they end up making a lot of money. I don't know, I love this story. I think it's wholesome, it's cute, but it has, you know, a little bit of mischief in it. And I just love imagining this half raccoon, half teapot, you know, on a tightrope doing a bunch of backflips or something like that. And this wholesomeness is not only seen in this story, but it's also seen in the Ghibli film Pompoko. Basically, the film shows the struggle that a group of tanuki have with, you know, the growing urban development in their countryside home. It's amusing and downright hilarious, actually, to see how the tanuki mess with the humans throughout the movie. But over time, their efforts become frivolous and the humans basically win the war. Their development is complete, the humans move in, and the tanuki are forced to adapt into their new life, either posing as humans or just scraping by as raccoons. However, even though they have to bear the unbearable, they do so with a smile. They push forward with hope, and they find happiness despite the hardship. Even though they had everything taken away from them, they're able to live happily and even with purpose. So even though the tanuki can be merely seen as, you know, silly creatures or cute mascots, I think that they actually teach us a really valuable lesson. They teach us to be ourselves despite the hardship and troubles that we face. The tanuki used their abilities and their talents without fear and to their fullest extent. And even though they did face the unbearable, they continued to love life. You know, at least from what I've researched and what I've seen in Pompoko, I'm no expert in folklore. I'm just a big fan and I could be missing some details, but this is the theme and this is the message that I've picked up on from the tanuki. And, you know, besides the tanuki, there is so much to love and appreciate from folklore. And if you haven't done so yet, I encourage you to look into some of them. It's so cool. It's enlightening. It's entertaining. And it can even be a little bit scary if you're into that kind of thing. And I love it. And who knows? Maybe I'll tell you some more folktales around this cozy little campfire in the future, huh? But in the meantime, though, remember this, tan tan tanuki's balls, even though there is no wind, they swing. Oh man, catch you later folks. Hey folks, thank you guys so much for watching this video. I was planning on doing, you know, some cute green screen on camera chiz, but it didn't really work out and I don't know if I'm totally feeling it, but maybe I'll try it in the future. But in the meantime, just enjoy the sound of my voice, okay? But thank you guys so much for subscribing and watching. And if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe. Spank that subscribe button, plus, and spank that like button. Spank whatever you want, as long as it's okay and legal and all. Okay.